Hey there, everybody. This ginormous freaking box just arrived today. It's split open and crushed on the one side. Let's get it open, see what's in there. Okay, this is what was inside the box. SP53 Bolo knife with nylon sheath. You've probably seen other people review it. All right, there it is. Look at that nylon sheath right on top. It's got a plastic insert in there to stop the blade from cutting the nylon. It's got two eyelets so you can put a leg tie on it. It's got, oh, really stiff snap. It says 1889. Same on this snap. And this is an adjustable snap up here. And this can swing back and forth. So if you're right or left hand, carry, that's good. It's got an okay size belt loop on it there. Says OKC 1889 Ontario Knife Company, and you can see that it is MOLLE compatible. You can hook it to a backpack or a bag, even a tactical vest. This is pretty huge though, but let's see here, I'll slide this back. All right, here is the knife. There's your warranty card. They gave you a little shoestring, a lanyard for the handle here. But this is what everyone's here to see. So let's see it. All right. Here it is. This side says SP53 Bolo. And this side says Ontario Knife USA. Because these are made in the USA out of Ontario, New York. It's got the very hard rubber handle. It's got the bird's head pommel. It has a brass eyelet for a lanyard. And it also has the finger guard here in hard rubber, so that it protects your hand from sliding up on the blade. It has a little ricasso there. Probably just big enough to get kind of the tip of your finger in. And then get your thumb up there so you can do some fine carving. This is a very stout blade. It looks like a big fat quarter inch. And then look at this tip. Some of the black has been scraped off, it looks like. But that is a good looking tip on it. This thing is thick the whole way up. It's like a brick house. I guess it's just straight. It's not a drop point. It's not a clip point. It is a recurve blade on a kind of like a saber grind. It's got the big belly. Almost reminds me a little bit like a kukri. But obviously the whole knife isn't bent. So probably be a little bit harder to sharpen this area, but not too bad. Even though this is thick and not super long, so I would say it falls under the category of being a thick chopping knife. I think you have it listed kind of as a bolo machete, but it's way too heavy and way too thick to be a machete in my opinion. But yeah, looks pretty good so far. It's got that traction coating on it. I don't know what it's made out of. It's the traction coating. I think it's kind of like, it reminds me of Teflon. Kind of looks like Teflon. But let's check out the blade edger. Get the light to reflect on it just right. Doesn't look too bad. Just that little secondary bevel. Looks like it could use a little stropping, but not too bad. Nice and thick. Wow, that's a thick blade. It's got the belly here that swoops down. It's got like the ribbing for grip. A little bit flat on the top, kind of oval on the sides. I actually really like these handles a lot. They give you some really excellent grip. I see like a white line just above the blade edge there the whole way. And I see it on the other side too. I'm not sure what that is. It almost looks like it might have been an oil or a wax. I don't know. That's interesting. Okay, let's get some measurements. Okay, cutting edge is about 9.5. And it is 15 and about 1/4 overall. The handle where you grip it is about 5.25. And then you got this little extra space here. So, yep. Yep, you got a full 1/4 inch thickness there. So it's nice and thick, and it continues thick all the way up to like just this little tip right here. And that is still very stout. Okay, here it is inside the sheath, all buckled in. And you can see it's actually pretty silent, so it's not going to rattle around and make a lot of noise. That's good. Okay, here it is beside the Ontario SP10 Raider buoy. And they're pretty much identical in length. Now, they're both 1/4 inch thick. But if you notice, because this has the false edge on the top, that swedge, it gets real narrow. Near the tip. It's not super narrow, but it's narrow compared to that. Look how thick this one is. The bolo just stays very thick. See that difference there? That bolo is probably 3 or 4 times thicker at the tip than what the SP10 Raider buoy is. And that, I measured it up, it's a full 1/4 inch. And this one is also, so. I It's like this one sets higher too because of that big belly. I don't know if you can tell, but here, maybe I can do. Got the spines pretty lined up there. But see how there's a little bit more belly on the bolo. Maybe an extra quarter inch. All right, what the Raider buoy has going for it is this clip point blade and this metal hand guard. So you can buckle it in the sheath differently because of that, and it's designed more as a fighting blade. But still, it's thick enough to do bushcraft type stuff. This one up here is not really a fighting blade at all. It's designed to be a big chopper. It's for bushcraft. So you don't get the hand protection and you don't have the clip point to help you like lunge it into something, you know? But they're both designed for different tasks. Okay, you can see the sheath is a little larger on the bolo. But the SP10, you can wrap it over this way and the blade's on this side. So that protects that strap from the blade because you have that big hand guard. And obviously you cannot do that on this one because there is nothing to strap to on this side. So you always run the risk of the blade cutting that strap if you're not careful. Okay, this sheath is also a little smaller. This is the Bushcraft Woodsman from Ontario. Try to line these up a little bit. Yeah, just a little different. And this doesn't have a hand guard either. So you have to strap it on that side, whether you like it or not. See, in length, they're almost identical. Get a little more blade on this one. The blade stops clear up here on this one. And you can tell both of these are kind of meant for bushcraft, because they stay more stout all the way up to the tip. The bolo's much thicker though. This actually, believe it or not, measures up to a quarter inch. And this I think might just be slight hair over a quarter inch. Plus that black coating might make it appear like it's a little thicker. Okay, here it is, right out of the package. Got a sheet of printer paper here. Let's see if it arrived sharp at all. Yeah, not too bad. Seems like it cuts all the way to the tip. It even stabs pretty good considering how thick it is. Yeah, it comes with a pretty decent edge. Can't complain about that. Okay, there you have it. It's 15 and a quarter inches long, 9.5 inch cutting edge blade, 10 inches if you went all the way to where the handle starts. It's got a 5.25 inch handle there. A nice kind of stealthy nylon sheath without all the extra pockets and stuff on it, which I like. And this one is made out of 5160. Okay, the Ontario Bushcraft Woodsman is 420 high carbon stainless steel, and the SP10 Raider buoy is 1095 high carbon steel. This one is 5160 steel. So all three of them are different steel. And I guess over time, I'll be able to judge which one I prefer more. I've always liked 1095 high carbon steel. I've never had an issue with it. And 420 high carbon, if it's heat treated right, isn't too shabby either. I don't have a lot of experience with the 5160, so I guess time will tell. But I've only heard good about it. Well, that's all I have for this video. This is Joe Doomsday signing out.